Sejin here. Runway just released a feature that no other AI video platforms have even thought of, the motion brush. And yes, just as the name implies, the brush generates motion. But can it make the Mona Lisa smile? Let's use the brush to paint in a sloppy purple smile. Save and generate. Oh, what the? That's kinda weird. Let's adjust it a bit with more control. Okay, a slight head turn isn't too bad, but still not a smile. Let's do one more run and fine tune it a bit more. And still no smile. So how does motion brush even work? Keep watching to find out. If you like this sort of content, make sure you subscribe to this channel. Let's dive right in. Open up a browser and go to runwayml.com. If you've never used Runway before, click on the tutorial that's popping up on top for a quick tutorial. Log into Runway. I always like to start with my own images, so let's start by clicking on Start with Image. Here's your video generating prompt box with all its tools. And now they just added the motion brush tool. Click upload to choose the image you want to use the motion brush on. I'll use my mean looking fiery metallic skull for this tutorial. Once the image is uploaded, you can click on motion brush tool. Here you have your canvas that gives you full control of the motion brush. Up here, you can control the brush size from big to small. You can also control the eraser size as well. Now on the bottom, you have three main directional speed controls. Horizontal, vertical, and proximity. Horizontal controls how much speed you want to add to your motion from a max value of minus 10, being the maximum motion speed to the left, all the way up to the max value of 10, which is maximum speed to the right. Same goes for the vertical controls, where a max value of negative 10 is a maximum motion speed downwards, while a max value of 10 is a maximum motion speed upwards. Proximity is same, where the lower the value, the motion goes away from the camera, while the higher value, the motion goes towards the camera. Hitting clear will reset the values to zero. I'm going to create a burning motion on the fire around its head. While testing out the motion brush tool, I found out that the controls and the brush tools are quite sensitive, so you should loosely paint around the areas you want to create motion to avoid wasting credits. Flames normally go upwards, so I'm going to give it a vertical speed value of 6 and add a little proximity value of 2, and hit generate. The fire looks very realistic and the results came out pretty good. So what about the camera motion tool? The camera motion tool is independent of the motion brush, which means you will have to input the camera motion values afterwards. So I'm going to click on camera motion. I'm going to have the camera zoom in slightly and have it pan to the right. Save and hit generate. Use with caution. To save you time, I'm going to show you the different motion speed strengths for the motion brush tool. For the horizontal motion speed, I've used the values of 2, 6, and 10. You can see that the higher the value, the faster the motion. For the vertical motion speed, I've used the same values of 2, 6, and 10. Not too bad, right? What if you want the video to be longer than 4 seconds? Well, here's a quick trick that the pros are doing. Let me first generate motion on my Elsa image using the following settings. Once it's done generating, you'll need to download the video and go to finalframe.net. This platform takes a snapshot of the last frame on your first video, which you can then use to continue the motion on your first video. So let me upload the Elsa video by clicking on Add Video. Click on the download button on the final frame image. Click Download this frame. Go back to Runway and upload the final frame image. Paint in your motion and add your motion speed values. And hit generate. And there you go. It's not perfect every time, so you may have to regenerate it. Put the first video and the current video together using your favorite video editor and you're good to go.